Did you know much about Earl Campbell before you came to this franchise? And you know, have you gotten to know him at all through the franchise?
I mean, I did win the Heisman before I got here, but I watched Earl NFL Network when they showed NFL films backs in the 80s. He was a beast, a Ram, legend. So, yeah, I was very familiar with Earl. And I got to meet him a couple of times throughout my career.
Has he said anything as you kind of get close to, you know, some of his marks? Do you guys, communicate at all?
I don't talk to him on a weekly basis, but anytime I see him, it's always encouraging words.
Same with Eddie. I mean, you're getting close to some marks that he's set and helped set the standard for this franchise. When you're with those names and being mentioned, how nice is it to feel in that kind of company, Eddie and Earl?
Yeah, I mean, it's always a dream come true. You know, I was the kid looking at the TV, watching Eddie run, and like I said, watching Earl on NFL films and all the old film on him. And you know, they are the epitome of this franchise and, the running back position as far as how they played it, the physicality, the success they had. So definitely two guys that, you know, I looked up to and, it's a dream come true to have my name associated with.
Has Eddie been giving you a hard time at all, about getting close to his?
Well, he's coaching right now, so I haven't really talked to him much. But you know, anytime I see him or if he has something to say, he always reaches out.
How important is this game, Derrick, in your mind, coming off the bye, a division team, and trying to build some momentum here to start back?
Yeah, I think the bye week's a good time for everybody to get real well rested and come back flying around and get ready for a division opponent who we just played 2 weeks ago. So, we were very familiar with. We know what type of game it's going to be, a physical game, a hard match game. So, it's going to come out here and be able to work and improve and get better to Sunday.
Do those kind of games kind of like have like a buy one, get one free to it where, you get a win in the conference as well as a division? Do you look at it that way at all?
No. It's another division game. It's a good team, and it's going to be a battle in trenches.
Is it easier or harder to play a team so close together in a three-week span like this? Or is it any different than playing them 3 weeks ago and then playing them in December?
I don't really try to get into all that. I mean, our opponent is our opponent, and it's a division opponent who we just played 2 weeks ago. We know very well, so I mean, there ain't really much to it. Just go out there and play, execute, and do what we need to do to win.
Do you feel like there have been home run opportunities that you guys have missed out on, or that you guys haven't gotten to the verge of the home run?
I haven't been thinking about that, Paul. I mean, when it comes, it comes. And I'm not pressing, and whenever it happens, it'll happen.
Does it feel like maybe the rhythm is getting closer to, with the blocking? And, I mean, there's some new faces on that line, particularly with Taylor now out. Are things maybe getting a little easier, closer to that moment?
We're just trying to focus on executing and do what we need to do to be efficient, make plays, and I can do my job, running hard and finishing runs and doing all those things. I don't really get into all the other stuff about it. I mean, as long as we execute and do what we need to do, I think we'll have success, and that's what we need to focus on.
Derrick, for a long time, you've kind of gotten stronger as the game goes on. You know, a lot of breaking runs in the fourth quarter, that kind of thing. What's it going to take to get back to that this season? Has it been concerning to you that you haven't had a lot of success late in games this season?
I'm not concerned at all. It's a long season. Just have emphasis on it and work on it when we're out here. I mean, that's all you can do. And eventually, it'll happen. And, we got the guys that, that'll make it happen, but we just got to get better.
What do you make, Derrick, of the fact that you guys are so good in the red zone, but, it's been a different story trying to get to the red zone? Does that seem like a kind of an odd combination for the offense?
Well, when we get down there, we score, but we just got to get down there. I mean, that's just the only thing. When we get down there, we know we put points on the board, and it's just about getting down there and putting drives together, sustaining, and finishing with points.
Ryan started 48 straight games for this team at quarterback. With all the injuries you guys have had at other positions, how important is it that he's been able to answer the bell week after week for this team?
Yeah, he's a warrior. He's a leader of this team, and whatever he can do to help us win and make us better, that's what he's always going to do. And I respect him for it. he's unselfish, and you know he'll do whatever it takes to win.
What were you expecting from the Colts on Sunday? You guys beat them, and last time you played them, they've won two in a row, but certainly have had not a great streak against this team recently. You expecting a kind of a fired up, hungry team coming in here Sunday?
I think the Colts always come out and play hard. I mean, it's been that way since we've been playing them, so I wouldn't expect nothing less. Defense, they fire around, they're fast, they're physical, and you know that's how it's always been for them.
Well, can you tell us about Rachel Revis and maybe why you're kind of paying tribute to her today?
Yeah, she's my my girlfriend's aunt, battling cancer right now. I don't know, I mean, that's her personal business, but just want to shed a light on her. You know, with the platform I have, and you know, anything I can do to be a positive light to her, and you know, just let her know that you know I'm thinking about her, and you know, praying for her, and you know, while she fights, and you know, just stay strong, and God will take care of the rest.
Thank you.
So everyone, this is Tiny. The Titans are doing a great job of promoting adoption for dogs, and he's a very cute dog who needs a home. So if you guys get lonely and you know you need a friend, Tiny can be your best friend.
How'd you end up with Tiny as your dog?
I don't know, but I think Tiny's a good name. I mean, he's not too big, and I feel like he'd be exciting and bring some joy to your life. Y'all need a friend.
Derrick, do you like talking about dogs more than you like answering your questions about football?
Oh, it depends on the week.
Thanks, Derrick.
As far as self-scouting, and what are some things you liked, and what are some things you guys have got to do better here, to, you know, as you get going again?
Yeah, we definitely had a chance to dive into some things a little bit more in depth, you know, and take a peek at, number one, some things that we're doing efficiently and need to do a little bit more, need to call on a more frequent basis. Took a look at some things that maybe we had tried the first couple of weeks and have decided maybe they're not for us. And then certainly spending time trying to help the guys individually improve on their techniques and their fundamentals of the bread and butter schemes that we're asking them to do. So it was very valuable time, and I'm glad we had that time. Excited to try to implement the things that we looked at.
As you look at that and you try to decide, like, who should play more and who should play less, where does Chig Okonkwo come in that equation? Because he's had some recent success.
Yeah, I think he's done a nice job with all the things that we've asked him to do, and we're going to give him opportunities to improve. As Coach Vrabel's told you guys before, and we believe wholeheartedly around here, you know, you get the opportunities that you earn, and you know, Chig's done a nice job with everything that we've asked him to do to this point, and excited to see what else he can do for us.
When you have an opponent that you just saw and you're already very familiar with, does that give you more time during this time to do the self? Just kind of like you change it up a little bit because of that?
It was a pretty unique bye week in that regard, because we played them, you know, so closely to our bye week and the second time that we played them. And so it gave us an opportunity to kind of, you know, go back and reapply some of the things that we thought from the first game, maybe wanted to try in the second game and so on. You know, but you try to stay in a routine and a rhythm as well, and so you don't want to overanalyze or you know, have that paralysis by analysis. So there's a fine line there.
How did Derrick hasn't really hit a home run? 24 yards is his long thing. That's been a key to the offense. Do you think they've been there and you've missed them, or do you need to do better at kind of creating the opportunity for them?
Yeah, I think it's one of those things that falls into a couple different categories. Maybe it's finishing a little bit longer on a backside block. You know, maybe it's a missed opportunity or a shoelace here or there. And then certainly I'm always going to be self-critical and look for ways to try to get him out in space and make DBs tackle him. So I think all three of those components factor into that. And we believe we're really close. I think we've been really close on a number of runs. We just got to pop through.
For any kind of additional perspective on Derrick, when you see him approaching those records, like, you know, Earl Campbell, Eddie George, names like that, can you talk about that a little bit, about how kind of special that is?
Absolutely. I think when you're around somebody like Derrick, who has a chance to have his name written in history books, is a pretty special type of person to be around, because it takes a lot to get there. And I've been fortunate enough in my career in different stops to be around some guys that have approached some of those benchmarks before, the Randy Mosses of the world and Calvin Johnsons of the world. And it's unique to watch their work habits, and none of it's an accident. Those guys that have sustained success, it's the day-to-day that they put in. I know that sounds cliche and like coach speak, but it's true. Those guys that work really hard to take care of themselves, to be as consistent as they can, it shows up. Obviously, there's a lot that goes in before they even become pro football players, but that's certainly a common theme. I have a lot of respect for Derrick and the way he approaches the game and the way he handles his business. So it's fun for me to see that rewarded with things, that could bring him recognition. But the coolest thing about Derrick is the personal recognition is not as important to him as the team recognition and success. So I think that's, going to serve us well going forward.
With having to run so many players in and out over the last couple of years with all the injuries and whatnot, Ryan still managed to play in every game, and he's made 48 straight starts for this team. How important has that been to allow you guys to kind of keep your head above water?
Yeah, it's been critical. We've dealt with ebbs and flows in a lot of different positions, but when you have a quarterback that's as tough and sturdy as he is, it helps you remain a little bit more consistent and keep that foundation. And Ryan's toughness is extremely underrated, in my opinion. He stands in there. He shows up every single week, deals with all the nicks and bruises and never says a word. All the stuff inside the building, behind the scenes, the effort he puts in to be ready on Sundays, it's admirable and it's greatly appreciated, certainly by me and the rest of the staff.
Mike said yesterday that one of the things in the fourth quarter and in the second half that he felt was off was getting guys on the same page. To your estimation, what are some of those things that have been out of sync between guys that you guys need to clean up and make sure is cohesive as a unit?
Sure, maybe it's the second time we run a scheme, and we want to make a little tweak to how we're fitting a combination block or, a certain track we're taking. Maybe it's a motion landmark that we want to try to create something. Just getting those guys on the same page, either with some halftime adjustments or maybe some things that we didn't execute well in the first half and we try to come back and run them again in the second half. So we certainly need to be more detailed in the second half, and I look forward to, turning that page and kicking that door down here in the next second half of the season.
In the past, you've been able to rely on Derrick a lot as the games have kind of gone on, and you're still feeding him his carries, but you're not having the same success in the second half. Any reason why you think that is late in games?
Well, the easy answer is shots on goal. If you're only running 56 plays in a game, you don't have an opportunity to continuously, wear down the defense. And so we need to sustain drives better in the second half. That goes to third downs. We need to convert more third downs, particularly the ones that are in that manageable range. And we need to, find some ways to get some explosives, because it's hard in this league to have 12, 15 play drives, so we need to find some chunk plays in there and guys take advantage of their opportunities to make those plays.
Todd, if it's not too personal, I noticed your dad's name on your shirt. Can you kind of speak about maybe the impact he had on his life and maybe the ability to kind of honor him this week?
Yeah, no, I appreciate that opportunity, Jim. My dad passed away in 2004. Of lung and bone cancer. He was a lifetime smoker and started dealing with some respiratory issues and some back pain and different symptoms. But like a lot of people from that generation, didn't like going to the doctor, didn't like going to checkups, didn't like asking for help. And so unfortunately, by the time things got so bad, he had lung cancer that spread to the bones in his back and was kind of past the point of return. And so, honoring my dad with this shirt is also a way for me to explain to people that, hey, it's worth getting that checkup. It's worth going to the doctor. It's worth, letting somebody know that you have a minor health issue that you just can't get over, because you never know what it might end up being. And in my dad's case, who, like I said, lifetime smoker, probably had a pretty decent idea what it was. Sometimes people just don't want to look truth in the mirror, And so that, is a pretty cool opportunity that the NFL gave us to honor people. I wouldn't be here without my father and the way he raised me, the values he instilled in me, the work ethic he instilled in me. But I also want to honor him by saying maybe there's somebody else that could avoid the same fate he wound up with simply by getting a checkup.
Mike Vrabel mentioned a couple times that as well as Stonehouse has performed this year, that maybe last game wasn't necessarily his best. Are there there one or two things, you know, is it hang time, direction, anything like that, that he might need to work on?
Yeah, I think one of the things that we're working on the past couple of days has been his directional punting. You know, he's been doing a great job with hang time, obviously booming the ball, getting some really good yardage on it, but we want to really work on his consistency on his directional placement. And that's some of the things that we've been working on with him the past couple of days. And, you know, and he understands that, and our players understand it, where we want to punt the ball. So we're looking for a little bit of improvement on that. And obviously, again, he's doing a great job for us. But we still feel he hasn't even had an A game yet. That's how well he's been doing in practice. So we're hoping that translates into the games, and hopefully we can do even better.
Having a relationship with him before the draft, the way you did, how important do you think that was in convincing him to come here, even though you already had Brad?
Yeah, you know, I think that's something that we try to do, one, with all of our players, try to build a relationship. But when they're coming out of college, it's a little bit different because we got to recruit them, especially if, you know, they might not get drafted. So if we can build a little bit of a relationship beforehand, and when they're looking for a team to come to as an undrafted free agent, at least they'll have some, oh, hey, you know, Coach Auk and Coach Chase, they did a really good job recruiting me a little bit. But it is tough when you have a really good punter in Brett Kern to say, hey, listen, why don't you come in here and compete against Brett Kern, learn a little bit. If you don't win out, you know, that's okay. You're at least going to learn some stuff. So it was important for us to have that relationship with him beforehand.
Was it a priority for you at the time to try to find a punter, or was it more you like what you saw in him?
Yeah, I don't think we were really going out there and looking for a punter. It was something that we saw on film with him and said, hey, let's give this guy an opportunity to come in and compete for a job. And then obviously he just took off with it and ended up winning the job.
Self-scouting during the bye, what are some things you like about what you've seen so far from your group? Maybe what are some other areas you could improve?
Yeah, we like how hard our guys are playing right now. You know, just getting compliments from people from around the league of, you know, just how hard the players are playing for us right now, which says a lot about the guys because they're really taken to special teams and they want to improve and get better at it. So I think our effort has been good. We like our details that we're doing on our return units right now. Guys have really bought into the concept of what we're trying to get done. So that's been important. And I think we can always improve on tackling, you know, especially in space. And then just our one-on-one blocks, whether it be on kickoff return or punt return. So we'll continue to try to work on that too.
Is Josh Thompson a special teams ace?
I want to consider him an ace right now, but we're going to try to continue to work with Josh. That's one of the things that we kind of looked at when he was in college, how well he played on special teams. And then, you know, just looking at his preseason, he did a pretty good job there with Jacksonville. So, you know, he's going to try to find a role for this team, and if it's special teams, that's going to be great. We like how he's working right now, and he's meeting, and he understands some of the stuff on special teams that we're trying to do already. And we're looking forward to seeing if he can do some stuff on the field.
These guys have come in with big special teams reputations. As a group, is there a clock for when all of that should combine to a collective special teams success beyond what you've had?
Yeah, I mean, the more guys play together, whether it's reps out on the field or even game reps, the more that we can get, hopefully collectively we can continue to improve. And I think that's just going to help us out with more time, you know, on the game situations where guys are working together. They kind of understand what their skill sets are, what they're really good at, what they need to improve on, and guys can go and play off of those guys too.
You're never going to have consistent people? Isn't special teams
always
changing?
Yeah, oh, sure, sure, because it's always changing for us. And it is for everyone else, too. I mean, guys get hurt. Guys are coming in, doing different things. They might not play a position that they practiced, 2 weeks beforehand. We might have to move them. But they're professionals. They understand that they got a job to do, and whatever we give them, those guys are going to end up excelling in it.
Why is Kevin Rader seemingly a very good tackler for a guy who's an offensive special, skill set player?
Yeah. We saw some things last year with Kevin when he played for Pittsburgh, especially on their kickoff unit. He would go down there and make some tackles. I think that's just his mindset. You know, he's going to go down there and just be a football player, even though he is a tight end on offense. You know, I'm sure he played some defense in high school, and he just has that mindset that he doesn't matter if he's a tight end or not. He's just going to go down there and play with all out effort and make some tackles. But really happy with Kevin on how he's playing, especially this past game.
Normally with offensive players, offensive skill position, but do you have to kind of give them refresher courses on how to tackle?
Oh, sure. But I think Coach Vrabel does an unbelievable job. Some of the drill work that we do in practice, we're not just having defensive players go through tackling drills. We've got some offensive players that'll go through that. And Kevin obviously is one, Hassan Haskins, Cody Hollister, those guys that are playing on special teams that are offensive players, we are putting them in drills to make tackles in space. So I think that helps those guys.
Will there be opportunity for Kyle Phillips to get back there and return punts, or are you going to just stick with what you have right now?
No, I think there is an opportunity for Kyle to go back there. In fact, I just talked to him again, you know, tomorrow or yesterday that, hey, you could get an opportunity at any point in time, and we want you to be back there, and we want you to go out there and have a big 46-yard return like you did the first time. And, you know, great thing about him, and he's, yeah, Coach, I'll be ready for the next opportunity. So we'll see when that comes, but he's been working hard, and hopefully we can get him back there again.
You know, both their running backs out, and they kind of flipped the script and put it in Ryan's hands, and threw it 58 times, didn't turn it over, and, yeah. You know, they got the
Yeah, they did a good job. They did a good job protecting him. They did a good job getting the ball out of his hands in a timely manner. Again, I think the tempo kind of helped him as well. I mean, they mixed that in. I think there were over 30 snaps of tempo. So I think that played a part in well as well. But they did a good job. They did. They're getting the ball in the guys' hands that they had available, and they were making plays. And we're going to have to be ready to go to defend the pass, defend the run, defend it all now. So.
How much extra stress does that put on a defense with the lack of ability maybe to get guys a breather or substitute?
Yeah, I think the substitution is always a factor, being able to get guys on the field, get guys off the field. And I think just overall, just it kind of gets guys a little anxious, right? They're not really sure what's going on. Things are moving fast. I think it comes down to us being able to get the call and get communicated and make sure we're settled in before the ball snapped. If we can handle ourselves in a timely manner in terms of getting the call and we can get lined up and play, then it's just playing football like regular. But it does. It adds a little stress to our guys, a little anxiousness, just making sure we're able to get the call and get to where we're supposed to be before they're snapping the ball.
I was just going to say, Mike Vrabel said yesterday, X play is still kind of number one on the list in terms of things to work on. A little bit, you know, are you tired at all of kind of the repetition of this, you know, delivering that same message time and time again?
We gotta keep preaching it because we obviously haven't changed the trend. So we got to make them earn it. We do. We can't be getting the ball thrown over our heads. We got to be able to make tackles. We can't be not making mistakes with our execution that's causing some things at times. So, I mean, there's a ton of reasons for them. And we got to do a better job of eliminating them and making them earn it.
How much do you need personnel consistency there? You got DBs just coming through the door.
Yeah, that's part of it. I mean, and again, we're out here practicing, communicating. They're meeting all together. We walk through. The communication is a big part of it. I think any defense, any scheme you're in, that plays a major role. But making sure we're all on the same page and kind of got to overdo it right now based on what we got going on with the different people that have been cycling through. You got to overdo it, and guys got to take a role, and they got to be committed to communicating.
You mentioned overdoing it. Is there anything specific that you're doing differently in practice?
Yeah, I mean, we're working on different things. Playing the ball down the field is a big one. We got to make sure we're staying on top. I think going back to the last question, I think the communication aspect is coming into play, and then just cleaning up our coverage technique and fundamentals, right? Making sure we get to our landmarks when we're in zone coverage, making sure we got our eyes on our man when we're in man coverage, all the little details that go with understanding what coverage we're in and what concept that falls in, because there's a lot of different concepts that we play, and guys just have to understand the differences between zone, man, if we're playing some sort of match concept. So we're repping it, working on it. We know it's something we got to get fixed.
How much does getting Amani Hooker back go into that communication that you mentioned to have that consistently, getting a guy who's virtually a captain of the secondary?
Yeah, because he's played a lot of ball, and him and KB have worked hand-in-hand for a long time now. I think that's an added benefit for us for sure, is having him back, there to be able to communicate, where, again, it takes a little onus off of KB to do that. And with the different corners, different nickel at times, like, there's constant communication, whether it's full field, whether it's half field going on. So I think that'll be a big benefit for us getting him back.
Beyond the communication, what about just the playmaking for Amani coming back? And also, if you get Bud back this week for this matchup, what does that mean?
Yeah, I'm excited to get those guys back. They're out here working now. Again, I think the guys have stepped up and made some plays for us when they weren't out there. But it's always good to get those guys back. I'm excited to kind of see Bud go on Sunday, cut it loose. He's had a good few days of practice here. And then obviously with Hook's just consistent, reliable. He makes the plays he's supposed to make. He's rarely in the wrong spot, you know. So he's just somebody you put out there, and you never really have to worry about him.
What do you want to see from Monty Rice before he can move back from special teams type, playing a role defensively?
Yeah, he's progressing. I think he's getting better each day. Just, again, he's missed all of spring. He missed all of training camp, so there's a lot of reps. And we always talk about that year one to year two. That's where a lot of growth comes into play for a lot of these guys. So just continuing to work out here on the practice field, and I see improvement each day. There's just always new things that are showing up with him that he just hasn't seen in a while that we just got to work through.
Mike's talked a lot about maybe during the bye week is finding guys who deserve to play more, maybe guys not play quite as much. I mean, do you have that? Are you looking for those players in your side of the football?
Yeah, we want all these guys to earn it. You know, like, we got 53 on the roster, 16 on the P squad. We're elevating P squad guys every week. We want these guys to earn it. Nothing's handed to them. If they are playing a lot and they're not doing so hot, like, they don't deserve to be playing so much, right? So each day in practice, each day, each Sunday that we're out there, like, these guys got to go out there and earn it. And that's a benefit if you got a competitive roster, and these guys that are hungry, that are coming in new or on the P squad, they show their improvement in practice. It's like, well, it's time to – let's give this guy a chance.
Dylan Cole, kind of an example of that, a guy who's taken an opportunity that maybe was unexpected and kind of run with it?
Yeah, and I think he was forcing the fire a little bit with the injury as well. But, yeah, I think he's done a really good job for us, stepping in for Zach here these past few weeks. And he's improved. He has from early on, whatever that role was, special teams, mixing in to play some linebacker or on certain packages, to now – playing the bulk of those snaps. Like, you've seen improvement from him, and I think his comfort level being out there has improved.
Touched on the DB.
Yeah, so this is my mother-in-law, one of the toughest people I know. Got diagnosed with breast cancer in 2018. Still battling, still fighting every single day. Would never know that she's got breast cancer around my kids, everybody else. So, proud of her, happy to represent her this week.
It helps at the same time. You never know what they might come out there and go throw out there at us. But at the end of the day, like, we're kind of familiar with the players, familiar with the team. So just go out there and do what we got to do.
For the bye week and just for you personally, good to get some rest. And how much do you now look forward to kind of full steam ahead, knowing that that's in the past?
Yeah, definitely needed to get rest. A lot of guys had to come back and get our mental together. But we're looking forward to going on this run. Just going out, have fun, enjoying each and every day, and preparing to win for every game.
We talked about the second half offense, maybe just starting with getting those first downs. And what else is it going to take to get that going through not only the third but the fourth quarter as well?
Just got to go out and fight and hone in on our details. And at the end of the day, it's like one play at a time, one drive at a time. Just go out there and put something together. It'll be a game to win.
How beneficial is it for you and Derrick Henry to not only be backs, but also being really utilized in the pass catching game as well?
It's great. But at the end of the day, it's not about me. It's about the team, how we can put together a win. And, like, however the team needs me, the players need me, I'm here for them, and we're just going to go out there and put a game.
How about the importance of just getting that second win over the Colts and, sweep the series before Halloween even gets here?
Yeah, we're here to try to win every game, you know what I mean? So we're not too much honing in on what that's next game, next opponent. So that's how we're looking at it.